Good morning, students. Hello, everyone. So again, we are here with your accounts class. So we have completed chapter number 1, that is Introduction to Accounting. Hope you all have now learned its objective, solved the worksheet, and prepare your notes. And I hope that the chapter is now all clear. You don't have any doubts regarding that chapter. So today we are going to start with our next chapter, that is chapter number 2, Basic Accounting Terms. In this chapter we are going to learn about different accounting terminologies which you will see in different chapters, upcoming chapters, and in that chapters you will be able to understand them properly if you have thorough knowledge of those terms right now. So we are following T.S. Garhiwal's double entry bookkeeping for studying accounts. Learning objects of chapter number 2, basic accounting terms. First of all, describe, explain, and integrate fundamental concepts underlying accounting and finance, management, marketing, and economics. These accounting terms are not only limited to accounts, but it is all related in the fields of finance, management, marketing, and economics. Use information to support business processes. So once these terms are clear, business becomes easy to regulate and practice, such as problem analysis and decision making. So today we are going to study about the following terms. First of all, event, transaction, vouchers, debtors, creditors, purchases, sales, goods traded in, stock, profit, and loss. We will learn about all these items in detail with relevant examples so that these accounting terms are clear to all of you. These accounting terms explain the concept and role of accounting and financial reporting in the market economy. All the accounting terms listed above explain the regulatory framework of accounting activities, and moreover, these accounting terms explain all accounting techniques, the principles which is to be followed in business. Okay, now what are accounting terms? Technical words which are commonly used in accounting are called accounting terms. It is essential to know their meaning because without their knowledge, our accounting subject will be incomplete. So first of all, the first very first term which we are going to discuss is transaction and event. Okay, all of you have heard about a name of Hamdard. It's a company, it's a Ayurvedic pharmaceutical company producing a variety of products. Okay, tell me that these days as peak summer season is now. So, how many of you are enjoying chilled Roo Afza drinks at your home? So, that product is a Hamdard product. It is a product of Hamdard company. Now, Hamdard is a NPO. Hamdard means non-profit organization. NPO stands for non-profit organization. In the previous week also, we have done one term, that is fund accounting. Types of accounting, when we have covered branches, we have covered fund accounting. In that, what we have done, that accounting done for non-profit organizations like orphanages, Pingalwada, blind homes, old age homes, charitable trust, and or we can say the business houses which contribute maximum of their profit towards charity purpose, that is a NPO, non-profit organization. That is, their main purpose is not to seek profits but for the welfare of the society. So its name is Hamdard Wakf Laboratories, or we can search it at hamdard.in. It's a Unani and Ayurvedic pharmaceutical company in India. It's a very old company established in the British rule, that is 1906, its founder was Hakim Hafiq Abdul Mazid. Okay, many of the products which we can have of Hamdard company, which we use, are Sharbat Ruhafza, Safi. Many girls drink Safi, na? They take Safi as a medicine. Rogam Badam Shireen, many people take it. Sualin, it's again a medicine. Joshina, Sinkara. So these are the products which is manufactured by this company. Moreover, all the units which are in different cities producing these products are Hamdard Foundry Works. They are called Hamdard Foundry Works, and they work in that. We have also one in Amritsar at Sultanwind Road. Okay, before proceeding, let me tell you one very interesting fact about this company. In November or December, when our relation with Pakistan, that India's relation with Pakistan after surgical strike and terrorist attack, so all those events, so what happened there, that production of this product was almost banned because its origin was in Pakistan, as it was founded before partition. So it was banned earlier due to its foundation, migration and India's conflicts with Pakistan. But due to peak summer season and demand, and moreover, now a company which is running for more than 60-70 years in a particular country, so that is not easy to finish, or that is not easy to stop its production. So it is again become operative, and this is a current news within in the last week that it will become operative again. So when we talk about this company, if we have to cover two terms like transaction and event, if they produce raw material, then it is an event. If their asset depreciate, suppose I am talking that their production was banned for some period, that time no plant was in function and the value decreases, so that is an event. Now the one who are working there, employees, the persons who have invested there, they are also interested in them, but they are getting no profit, no loss, no share. So this is an event. Now we have two types of events. One is internal event, other is external event. Talking about the same company, changes within the management, change in asset, liability, income, within the company's position, that which is reflected in profit and loss account, balance sheet, is called an internal event. And all those informations which are disclosed to the public, like closure of the firm, lockout, so what is it? It's an external event. So we can say here, an event is a change in an item that should be reflected in the company's financial statements. For example, change in their assets, liabilities, revenue, expenses, or owner's equity. Okay, we were discussing about two events. One is external, another is internal. Events which involve a change between the business and its external environment is called an external event.
increase in the price of raw material, products or services, occurrence of a natural disaster, change in law, change in economy. So what is an external event? Now what is an internal event? Event that involves a change within the business. For example, consumption of raw material in the manufacture of product. Consuming raw material, that is internal event, and increase in price of raw material, that is external event. So we have one more term to discuss here, another term, that is transaction. These two terms are related. A transaction is an event itself that involves exchange of value. Value means money, between two parties, entities or parties, where one party receives, other party sacrifices. For example, selling of products, receiving of payments. So these are accounting events. They are of financial nature. They can be recorded and they are recorded in the books of accounts. When a particular state of business is recorded in the books of account, it becomes a transaction. When it occurs, when a particular state of business occurs, then it is an event. When it is recorded in the books of account in the value of money or money's worth, it is called a transaction. So we can say here, when an event brings change to account balances. Suppose I have purchased raw material. Now I am recording that raw material purchase in my account, profit and loss account or trading account. I am recording it. Then it becomes a transaction. If it is affecting the money part of account, then it is referred as a transaction. For example, a producer cannot produce any product without raw material. So also, accountant cannot claim accounts without a transaction. Like, a producer cannot produce anything unless he buys certain raw material from a market. So it is an essential part for a producer. Similarly, recording of events becomes transaction and they are necessary for accounting purposes. Simple meaning of transaction is to give and take. For example, sale, purchase, receive, payment. So that is a transaction. Now there arises a difference between a event and transaction. Let us understand with the help of an example. A death of a skilled employee may bring heavy loss to a business. Suppose in a business, a very dedicated employee, if he die, then this is a loss to a business. Business has to suffer, but this loss is not measurable in terms of money. It is an event for a business, but it is not a transaction because it cannot be recorded in the books of accounts. So this is the basic difference between event and transaction. So another example which we can take here, say transfer of goods. If goods get burned in a fire breakout, goods are burned in a factory, then burning of goods is an event. Recording of value of burnt goods is a transaction. Also, events can be private, corporate or charity. If seminars and conferences are held within the organization, they are private events. Suppose if a company hosts a golf tournament for its employees, or a match between the employees of the organization or outsiders, then it's a corporate event. Corporate means a company. Then suppose a trade show is organized
by the company to display goods, then it is a charity event. For example, every year in winter season in Amritsar, Pytech's sale is there in Ranjit Avenue ground. So what is that? A company is going for a charity event. So what is a transaction and event now? Transactions are those events which can be expressed in the terms of money and which brings changes in the financial position of an entity. So, next accounting term which we are going to discuss is vouchers. The written document through which a financial transaction is recorded is known as a voucher. It is also called payment run and it's a record of manual payment. It is an evidence. Moreover, every transaction when you record it in the form of a prescribed format, it is called a voucher. For example, if I bought goods from company A, company A make a bill and describe in detail how many goods I have bought, at what price I have bought the same goods. They wrote each and every description in the form of a prescribed form, and that form is called a voucher. So we also have a discussion of a format of voucher. So how does a voucher look like? That is, first of all, the name of the party and address is written, right? C company, the mall, Amritsar, fine. Then we put date, right? Date is 18 May 2019. Voucher number is given. Now this voucher number is only for office use because they have to keep a record of the transaction by its number. Now what I have purchased? 100 bulbs at the rate of 30 per bulb. So cost is 3000. Now I have purchased it on credit. I have not paid anything. So they will write my name here and the amount. One side manager would sign, on another side accountant would sign the same. This is a source of information from which accountant can gather and collect data. Also, we have different types of accounting vouchers. One is a cash voucher, another is non-cash vouchers. Cash vouchers means in which we have transactions all in cash. There is no credit, there is no delay in payment. I purchased goods from company B, I make payment in cash, and that record of information in a format is a cash voucher. Now, cash voucher can be a debit voucher or it can be a credit voucher. It can be in the form of cash or check also. We also make payment through checks. So, a debit voucher is which shows inflow of cash. B company receives from Rajan 70,000 rupees on account of sale. This is a debit voucher. Now, Rajan paid 70,000 to B company on account of sale. It's a credit voucher. At the same time, the same event recorded, it becomes debit voucher for one party who is selling and receiving cash. On the other hand, other party who is purchasing and making payment receives a credit voucher. Another type of voucher we have, non-cash vouchers. One it is transfer voucher, other it is supporting voucher. So these are documentary evidences. They, like, goods are sold on credit, as we have just discussed in format. 100 bulbs were sold at 30 per bulb. So it's a transfer voucher. Goods have been transferred. Possession has been given. Goods are in use now, but the transaction is not completed. It will be completed only when the voucher is transferred. Suppose I go to the market to buy a refrigerator on EMI basis. EMI means easy monthly installments. So, first of all, I make a lump sum payment that is called down payment, which becomes my cash voucher. Then I make a promise to give annual installments of 8,000 each in 8 months. Then those record of 8 installments by the way of checks. The company from whom we buy goods on EMI basis, they always take check from us for the next 8 months. Then those checks are transfer voucher. Next we have supporting vouchers. Now what are supporting vouchers? Transaction was buying of refrigerator. Checks were transferred. Those checks and the whole documents involved. Whenever you go to buy a particular product on EMI, the seller always tells you that 500 is for file processing. They take 500, which becomes a cash voucher. Now all those files which is maintained, like how much amount I have given, how much I will give, in what period it will be continued. So what is that? It is a supporting voucher. Now that file is a supporting voucher. Also we have gift vouchers. Okay, many of you do online shopping. Many of you have apps in your phone like Flipkart, Amazon, Snapdeal. So they provide you with coupons or vouchers. Sometimes you must listen from any of your known. I have a voucher today. I am going for a movie. I have a food voucher. So what it would be, they will show a detail that this transaction, I have bought a set of headphones from Amazon. Now, due to its sale, I have earned a food voucher of rupees 200, which I can spend only in watching a movie at the respective theater. So, you can also earn a housing, a travel voucher. Whenever we go for holiday, we plan for holidays, we have travel vouchers with us, which help us to take concessions at the time of making payments. So, the vouchers are the document that establish a transaction has taken place and they act as an evidence. Every bill, every cash received is a voucher. Next comes debtors. The person, firm, and organization who takes goods or services on credit from the business are called debtors. On the other hand, the person, firm, or an organization from whom goods are purchased on credit are called creditors of the business. Okay, let me clear you this with the help of example. Suppose Alpha Company lends money to Charlie Company. Alpha Company has given some amount of money to Charlie Company. Now, A Company, that is Alpha Company, is a creditor because it is giving money. Then Company C, that is Charlie Company, is a debtor because it is receiving money. The person who is receiving money has to pay back money. He becomes a debtor of the company. The company who has lent money to other becomes a creditor because they have lend money in the form of credit. When we talk about number of persons from whom the business has to take money, so collectively they are called as book debts or trade creditors. And on the other hand, all those persons to whom company is liable to pay are called trade creditors. Next term we have is goods bought for resale are called purchases. When we purchase goods to convert them into finished goods for resale, they are called purchases. And they are of two types, cash purchase, credit purchase. Rajan bought 72 pieces of wire net, that is called a purchase. Now, if he makes payment, then it is a cash purchase. If he promises to make payment, then it is a credit purchase. If an asset is purchased, suppose you buy a car, suppose you buy a LED TV, it's your asset, you live in your own home, then it is not a purchase. It is only considered as your asset. It is not considered as purchases. Now, on the other hand, when we talk about sales, goods are sold to earn profit. We have purchased raw material, we convert them into finished goods, then we sell those goods at a higher margin involving all our cost. It is called profit. It is called a sale at profit. Now, sales again are of two types, that is cash and credit. When we sell goods and receive payment in the form of cash or check, it is called cash sales. When you sell goods but the promise is there to make payment within a month or 2 months, 3 months, then it is credit sale. For example, for an organization in the business of making and selling aircrafts. So you see all aircrafts around you, different airline companies. So aircrafts are goods of aircraft company. Then they buy goods from Gulfstream, Challenger, Phenom, King Air, Pilatus. So all these are the companies who manufacture aircrafts. These are the purchaser. They purchase, they manufacture aircrafts. And now we are talking about Director General of Civil Aviation. So this is an association which purchases products, which purchases aircrafts from the manufacturers. Here they conduct purchase and this Director General of Civil Aviation conduct sales. They are the sellers and Director General is the buyer here. Our next very important term is profit or loss. Suppose Ratna is a trader of pineapples. He is a wholesale trader. He bought 12 dozen at the rate of 156 per dozen. So what is the cost price? 12 into 156, that is 1872. Cost price per pineapple, that is for every piece, is rupees 13 for him. For Ratna it is 13, that is 1872 divided by 12 into 12, 12 dozens, and every dozen contains 12 pieces. So when 1872 divided by 144, it gives you rupees 13. Ratna then sold every single piece for rupees 40 each. It means now per dozen will cost 480, that is 12 into 40, 12 pieces in a dozen and 40 rupees per piece. Now per dozen will cost 480. Earlier it was 156 per dozen, now it becomes 480. So his total sales are now 5760, 480 per dozen and number of dozens 12. So what is his profit here? Selling price minus cost price, that is 3888. 3888. If we go for another side, suppose he sell every piece at the rate of 10 per piece, then he will go through a loss. So difference between the cost price of a product and its selling price involving different cost in it is declaring about profit or loss. So these were the accounting terms which we have to discuss today. Rest accounting terms we will discuss tomorrow, because we have so many accounting terms to discuss about. For the clarity of the concepts, for the clarity of these terms, do follow the given link and read the PDF sent to you for your chapter. Answer the questions: what are the two criteria that must be met to consider an event as a transaction? Second question: how do you calculate profit or loss? Question number third: what account is purchases? Thank you.